Let us now install the Apache Tomcat web server, and you can do this by clicking on the Apache Tomcat link that you see on the installation page of our website. This will bring you to the download page of the Apache Tomcat web server. If you scroll down, you will see that they offer you a choice of different type of installers that you can download. Click on the README file to see what each of these installers contains. If you are on Windows, you can download the Windows Service Installer. Once you have downloaded the installer, you can run it by simply double clicking on it. Follow the installation wizard by accepting the defaults, and when you are finished, Apache Tomcat service will be installed on your computer. Once you install the Apache Tomcat server, you can look at its service by going to Start, Control Panel, System and Security, Administrative Tools, double click on Services, and at the very top you will see the Apache Tomcat service. Its status should be started, and on the left you will see the options for controlling Apache Tomcat service. By default, the Apache Tomcat server runs in admin mode. To make it work properly with NestEgg, we need to run it in user mode. To do this, right click on the Tomcat service, select Properties, go to the Logon tab, select this account, and then type .backslash and your Windows username. For example, my Windows username is mlavanis, so I have entered here .backslash mlavanis. After that, specify the password with which you log on into Windows. Confirm your Windows password and then click OK. With this, Apache Tomcat has been set up to run with NestEgg. Let us now download NestEgg and deploy it on the Apache Tomcat web server. To download NestEgg, click on the link that you see for NestEgg on the installation page of our website. This will bring you to the project page of NestEgg on Google Code. Here you will see two files for download. You want to download the file which says NestEgg with the latest version number. The name of this file will be NestEgg-versionNumber.war. You can download this file by right clicking on it and selecting Save Link As. This file needs to be saved to the web apps directory of Apache Tomcat. So you need to go to the directory where you installed Apache Tomcat, and in my case it is /Program/Files/Apache-Software-Foundation/Tomcat, and here I see the web apps directory. So I select the directory and I save NestEgg to this directory. Next, we want to download the JAS configuration file for the latest version of NestEgg. The name of this file will be nestegg.jas.conf. To download this file, right click on it and select Save Link As. This file needs to be saved to the JAS directory in your home directory. So go to your home directory, which in my case is /users/mlavanis. This is the default home directory in Windows. Here you need a directory called JAS, which is capital J-A-A-S. If you do not have such a directory in your home directory, you please go ahead and create this directory. You can create a new folder by clicking on the new folder option that you see here. Once you have created a directory named JAS, all capitals, you can select that directory and save your nestegg.jas.conf file to that directory. There is one more thing we need to do to complete our installation of NestEgg. we need to modify the java.security file so that it knows where to read the JAS configuration for NestEgg. This file is usually located in C, Program Files, Java, JRE6, Lib, Security. Let us now go ahead and open this file and modify it. But before we do that, let us go back to our services, select Apache Tomcat, and stop the service. This will ensure that we do not modify the file while the service is running. We can now open the Java security file. Please note that this is a simple text file and you can open it in your favorite text editor. After you open this file, scroll down till you see a section for setting the login configuration. It will have a comment which says default login configuration file. Here, copy paste the line that you see on the installation page of our website. And let me open that for you. So this is the line on the installation page of our website. And all you need to do is copy paste that line right here in your java.security file where you see the default login configuration comment. Once you have done that, you can save and close this file. At this point, you can go back to your Windows services, select Apache Tomcat, and start the service. Once the service is started, we are all set to start using NestEgg. To access NestEgg, point your browser to your server :8080, which is the port number, /NestEgg/login. In my case, I'm running my Apache server on my local machine, so I point my browser to localhost :8080/NestEgg/login. The first time you access NestEgg, it will direct you to the page for creating a user account. To do this, enter the username of your choice, a password of your choice, confirm your username and password, and click Create. Once you create your user account, you can start using NestEgg by logging in. At this point, the installation of NestEgg is complete. If you encounter any difficulties installing NestEgg, please let us know by visiting the support section of our website at www.fastkangaroo-software.org. Thank you very much.